This is for PM. What about vapor? So your there's a bunch of things we talked about for sampling of PM using impactors and all that. How do we do vapor phase analysis? Vapor phase, but in the atmosphere we have everything, vapor phase and PM. We only want vapor phase. The first thing we need to do is cut off the particles. So you need a filter. So a vapor phase is at the downside of the filter paper usually, yeah. And so we use an airstream. We have a pre-filter filter here which takes out all the particulate matter, and then we use an adsorbent typically. Now before we go to this adsorbent, now vapor phase, there are two kinds of vapor phase analysis that is done. Suppose, what is the simplest method? When you are sampling, when you want to sample, why are we sampling in a filter paper in for PM? What is the basic reason? We are sampling material in a filter paper over a period of time, and the reason we are doing that is, what is the main reason we are doing it? That we have instruments like the real-time instruments, yeah, but that is one way. But if you are doing the PM method, why are we doing the PM method with the filter and this thing?
Composition.
Composition. But no, why are we doing it over a period of time? Why do we need to accumulate sample? We are accumulating sample because it's quantifiable mass. We need to measure it. The mass is measurable, so below detection limit, so it's not easy to measure. So preferably, I would like to just take the vapor sample as it is and measure it, okay. So sampling, one method of sampling is what is called as grab sampling. This is what you do in water also. In water you take sample, you grab a sample in a container, yeah. I can also grab a sample of air in a container. What's the problem? So you have to talk about again sampling all the way to the instrument. What prevents me from doing it? If I can do it, I will do it. But if I can't do it, what is preventing me from doing this? What is my constraint? Grab sampling essentially means I take some volume of sample and I analyze it, yeah, as it is. So if I am doing grab sampling, I have to define a volume. There is a certain volume. I take gas or vapor in that volume and I directly go and take a sample and inject it into a GC or HPLC or something and get some signal, or I have a sensor that will directly. If I can put a sensor directly, I don't even have to do grab sampling. I am just directly measuring it. So, but many times we don't have those sensors, so we have to do this sampling. So a grab sampler is done when the concentration is is high enough to directly for direct analysis, no processing required. Which are the do you know which are the possible candidates for this? The concentration of something of interest is fairly high and you don't even have to do any processing. Any processing, by processing we mean concentration or any such thing. We don't have to worry about increasing the concentration in the sample in the instrument. Directly it's reasonably high. So which are candidates for this? Which sources are candidates for this? What sampling? Can you think of anything that we can do? Grab sampling. We can do grab sampling for anything, but which do you think will work? Where do you think you will have high concentrations?
Near to a source,
very source. Can you give an example?
Stacks,
very close to industrial chimneys. Do you know a stack that is accessible to you easily? Stack means we are talking about a combustion exit, right?
Automobile.
So you have automobiles. I want to measure what happens to an automobile stack. So what happens to a stack? Very close to the stack, the concentration is high. It's coming from here. The moment it gets out, it is mixing with the atmosphere and dispersing. Concentration rapidly decreases. Okay, so if your stack is emission source is here, this is a source. Right here, if you want to measure, I can use grab sampling, it may work. But if I am using somewhere far away, I am standing in the middle of the road and I am trying to do grab sampling, chances are it may not work, okay. So, this is a question of source sampling versus ambient sampling. The ambient sampling is general atmosphere. I want to know what is the average concentration of some compound there. So, grab sampling may not work. If I do grab sampling, I may get nothing. So, I will, you know, people can make the wrong inference that there is nothing there. So, that is the biggest danger that we have. So, we will do, when you can do grab sampling, we will do grab sampling. Grab sampling is done for, how do you grab sample an air volume? Water, you can open a container, it will go nicely. How will you do that with air? The biggest problem with air is you can't see it, you can't see the sample is there. That's one of the main problems in air, okay. This is so there are ways to work around that. So how do you sample air? How do you grab sample? How do you grab a piece of air?
Vacuum.
You use a vacuum pump. So if you want a fixed volume, how do you do it? If I want to say I'm giving you a sample, how will I give you a sample? Your vacuum pump is correct, but can you elaborate a little more? So your container itself, so one, what is one possible container for a grab sample? You need a container, right? What container will you use? So you can use a cylinder. For all gas storage, everything we use a cylinder, except we use a small cylinder which has a valve. You have a valve here, this is a cylinder, and we also have some kind of a pressure gauge which shows that there is gas inside, otherwise you do not know if there is gas inside. So what we do is they pull a vacuum on this thing and then they close the valve. So the contents of the container are in vacuum. When you want to sample, I open the valve, air from outside will go in, and you let it equilibrate and then you close the valve, that is a sample. So as long as there is no leak in the valve here, your sample is secure, and you can see it by, you need a very sensitive gauge, because it will be vacuum and then it will go to atmospheric pressure. So it will be at atmospheric pressure, almost atmospheric pressure when you are equilibrating, and it will stay there. And unfortunately, you can't, unless you have a very sensitive pressure gauge, you can't see. The only way you can see it is if you pressurize it more than atmospheric, it will go up beyond that, and then it will, if you see a leak, it will start coming down. But if you have atmospheric pressure, it, usually the gauges are not very sensitive. But anyway, this is one way of doing it, and you take it to this thing, and you, from here you can, there are ways in which you can take a sample into a syringe for a GC or, so there is another way of analysis in GC which I have not talked about. We will talk about it in the next, I think today's class is almost done, tomorrow we will talk about it and finish it off. There is another way which is called as a, this is called as a canister, and there is another instrument which is called as a Tedlar bag. Tedlar is the name of a material. This is like a plastic bag. So here same way, you evacuate it using a vacuum pump. And you can see this plastic bag like a balloon, it will puff up. You can see that it has air sample, that is the advantage of the plastic bag. But of course, it is plastic, so there is always possibilities of one of your chemicals adsorbing on plastic and you are losing things. So the canisters are usually stainless steel or some such material which do not, organic analysis is simpler. But the plastic bags are nice because you can see if there is gas there or no gas there, and then you can put a small, I will have pictures of it, I will show you pictures of it tomorrow, these things. So these are grab sampling. So if you do not have enough concentration, you have to accumulate, you can't do grab sampling, the concentration is not enough. So you have to accumulate volume just like we accumulate mass. So we use an adsorbent in this case. For trace analysis where grab sampling will not work, we send a volume of flow rate for a certain period of time. So for a certain period of time, we have a pump. And we have an adsorbent. An adsorbent, you choose a suitable adsorbent which is picking up, trapping all the vapor component, organic components that is of interest to you. So there are a lot of adsorbents that are available in the market which are generic adsorbent, which means that you do not know what is in the atmosphere, it is open. it will adsorb a wide array of compounds, okay, and then you can trap it here. So the adsorbent that is used in line with the flow. So after a certain sampling period, so adsorbent, if you use an adsorbent, Q is the flow rate of the air multiplied by the time will give you volume of air sample collected. Then you take the adsorbent and you have to, just like what we do, you have to extract the organic material from the adsorbent, and the mass of extract divided by the volume will give you the concentration rho A1. Yeah. But in the process of extraction, again there is a chance of a lot of losses that can happen, especially if you are looking at volatile organic compounds. If you are looking at compounds like benzene and all those things, they are fairly volatile. So in the process of extraction, they will come out, there you may have significant amount of losses in many of these things. So there are ways in which here, as well as in water analysis. Now this is the extra extended technique, that advanced techniques that people use to not to do manual processing, manual extraction and processing. There is automated extraction and processing, and how to do that. We will just look at those two cases and this tomorrow's class.